food delivered outside your door, fresh towels if you're lucky, but no clean sheets, and only short bursts of fresh air. For nearly 4,000 people aboard the Diamond Princess, this is no cruise. Conditions aboard the vessel, dubbed the prison ship, aren't exactly fit for a king. The cruise ship has been quarantined in Yokohama, and more than 60 passengers on board have tested positive for the novel coronavirus. But so far, only a few hundred of the 3,700 passengers have been tested, all of them restricted to their tiny cabins. But not all cabins are created equal. Matthew Smith, a passenger aboard the Diamond Princess, says some people are doing it tougher than others.
Our situation is actually a little more fortunate than many of our shipmates because we splurged for a suite on the vessel, which has given us access continually to the outside on our balcony. And so a lot of people are on the inside cabins. In fact, we got an announcement just about a half hour ago. They did the second round of letting the people in the inside cabins out for. So deck 14 inside cabins get an hour and a half out on the deck, although it's quite cold here. It's in the high 30s, but it's better than nothing, obviously, for them. But so we have a little extra space and have managed not to start killing ourselves yet. So it's been fine.
This is good news. So you're the lucky ones. What's it like for those other people?
Oh, you know, the last cruise we took with Princess about just under 2 years ago, we took an inside cabin. So we can really sympathize with them what it's like not to be able to leave a very small space. In the inside cabins, there's a desk and one chair and either two beds or one bed. There's just not hardly any room to move about. And so we're very sympathetic for them.
So have you been able to communicate with any of those people, Matthew? Is there any way of talking to other people on board at the moment?
Well, there's some, not with the interior people so much. There's actually one, there's a Japanese lady who I've just said hello to a couple times when I've opened the door, and she's opened the door across the hall. So we haven't been able to speak with them. Out on the balconies, there are people who lean out and talk to each other. But yeah, that's another point, is that the people in the interiors and the staff, they come by to drop off and the food. They've got 1,500 cabins to serve. Takes they've told us about 3 hours to do it, so they've got to keep moving. So there's, yeah, the people on the inside, not much opportunity for any kind of personal interaction. The cabin stewards will come by to pick up trash or towels or deliver new towels, but there's a lot of stuff they won't do.
So are your rooms still being cleaned, Matthew, when they're taking the towels and things? Is hygiene of paramount right now?
They will take the towels. Initially, they weren't doing anything with towels because we had they had to go back out sea to make more fresh water. So for the first day, they were not taking any towels, but that's fixed now. Yeah, so there's no problem with fresh towels. We haven't asked yet about being able to change the bed linens, although we're going to ask about that today. The restriction is the staff can't come into the cabins at all, so all they can do is either take something or bring something at the door. But yeah, they're supplying fresh towels and toiletries. They had yesterday, I think it was, or the night before last, they had made available a phone line for people to call and ask for sundry items to the extent they needed them. But at some point, we're going to ask later today about whether we can get clean sheets so we can change the bed, because they can't have the steward come in and do it.
Is it just the staff and the crew that are they're moving around the ship, or are there health authorities as well?
You know, there are health authorities, I know, on the ship. We were informed with the people that were allowed to go out on the deck. They let them out, sound like cages, but they tell them that a certain number. So this morning it was at 8:30. They said that the interior cabins on deck 14 are allowed out onto this one area on deck 15 for an hour and a half, and they've been instructed, they had delivered masks to us, face masks to us yesterday, so they're instructed, wear your face masks at all time and stay at least 1 meter away from any other passengers. So they're trying to give them fresh air, but, you know, minimize. And I and we were told that there were representatives of the health ministry up there on the out exterior monitoring, making sure people were following the rules. But since we have the access to the outside to minimize any contact, we're not going to actually go out any.
Right. And are you also being tested at any point, Matthew? Have you been tested for the coronavirus?
What they did the when they first before the quarantine started, what they did is the health officials came on board and they went cabin to cabin and did a temperature check with a probe in the ear, and if your temperature was fine, as ours was, they just went on. And my understanding from the information they received is if people showed either signs of a fever or were experiencing cough, because in addition to taking your temperature, they ask you, do you have a cough? Are you taking any medicine for a headache? And so if you were doing that, they then went and did my understanding is they took the blood testing.
That was Matthew Smith, a passenger aboard the Princess Diamond.